So Giga Austin is basically a done deal now. We're going to discuss what this will mean for the region of Austin, how many jobs will be created, and when we can expect the first Cybertrucks to roll off the assembly lines at Giga Austin. And then of course we'll also take a look at the progress of the other Gigas, especially Giga Berlin.
Then we have a funny court ruling against Tesla in Germany. News on upcoming electric cars, namely the Nissan Ariya and the BMW iX3, which certainly secures the title ugliest EV on this planet. But we also have lots of news on the Lilium air taxi. They are advancing like crazy. And of course, excellent news for Hyperloop. A lot to talk about as always, so stay tuned.
So, Giga Austin. We are really happy for Austin, a bit sad for Tulsa of course, but really happy for Austin, as this will certainly increase the attractiveness of this cool city as the tech capital of Texas even more. So the Travis County Commission, Travis County being the administrative region where Austin is situated, has approved the incentive package for Tesla Giga Texas or Giga Austin. This news was reported by the Austin Business Journal. They wrote, Tesla has now secured incentives from the county government and Del Valle ISD for a massive gigafactory in East Austin that could employ 5,000 and churn out Cybertrucks and other vehicles. And apart from quite credible sounding press releases, we also have more confirmation from our own sources, thanks to some amazing viewers, that Giga Austin is all but secured now. Thanks, Jackson, for this highly interesting info. So according to this source, Giga Austin will start construction already in the third quarter this year and will be finished by late 2021. The factory will cost $1.1 billion to construct, will have a footprint of 445,000 square meters, so more than twice the floor area than the current state of the Giga Nevada, and will be located on an 850-hectare land lot in East Austin. So yes, 5,000 new jobs in Austin by late 2021.
That is great news for the region. Unfortunately, this will also drive up real estate prices even more. And Austin wasn't cheap to begin with. This is of course the downside of a strong agglomeration of tech industry with lots of high-paying jobs. We can see that already to an extreme level in San Francisco. Austin is already seeing a giant construction boom. So a Tesla Gigafactory in the region will further increase that boom. So next time we visit Austin, the city will probably be totally transformed. At the rate with which new skyscrapers are popping up there, Austin will then probably look like this here. It will be a good starting point for our Cybertruck US road trip, which we are planning to do when Cybertruck comes out. Maybe even get them to give us a factory tour, which we of course would upload onto this channel. And we will also arrange some meetups across the US. It will be fun. Anyways, back on topic. So the Austin Giga Factory, as you know, will not only produce Cybertrucks, but also the Model Y.
And we strongly suspect that it will be expanded stepwise more and more in the coming years to also include huge battery production capacity and production of the Tesla Semi. Because Elon often talked about a Tera factory with 1 terawatt hour of battery output. And the Austin factory would be perfect for that, because 850 hectares is a lot of land. Thus, the factory can be expanded to a much larger size than the 445,000 square meters if the need arises. Infrastructure-wise, Austin is also perfect. It is even not so far from Boca Chica, and we know that Cybertruck will use a very similar steel to Starship's steel for its exoskeleton. and you can basically reach the whole US from Austin. And of course, you can attract very talented and smart people, maybe even lure them away from Google and other tech companies in the area. So yes, awesome news for Austin, and we cannot wait to visit Austin when the factory is finished. And if you like this video, you might want to consider subscribing to our channel to stay up to date with the latest news on disruptive technologies and spaceflight.
Meanwhile, construction work at Giga Berlin is progressing at high speed. Germany is really pulling a China here, it seems. The second cement mixing plant is now in place, as can be seen here. Fire protection walls are now already going up in the future paint shop. Foundation work in the future drive unit area is also ongoing. And how will this look when it's finished? Well, finally we have an official rendering from Tesla on Giga Berlin. And this here is how it will look. Pretty neat, huh? Complete with lots of solar panels on the roof. And apparently also a rooftop terrace for the employees to hang out and chill in the pauses. Really nice. Over in Shanghai, China, the Model Y expansion is now all but finished on the outside. And now Model Y production equipment is already being delivered and transported into the factory. According to Teslarati, the Model Y factory is currently being outfitted with more vehicle manufacturing equipment, which should pave the way for trial production runs of the Model Y to begin later this year. So yeah, it's looking excellent for Tesla, factory-wise, everywhere. New Tesla factories are just going up all over the world.
But now back to Germany. Just when you thought that German bureaucracy would start getting business-friendly, we have a judge ruling here from Munich, which bans Tesla from advertising the full self-driving features of autopilot.
Nein, 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 Tesla! Das ist strengstens verboten! Strengstens verboten! Das ist strengstens verboten!
This filing was brought forth by Germany's Wettbewerbszentrale, an industry-sponsored body tasked with policing anti-competitive practices. They argue that the average buyer might be given the impression that the car could drive without human intervention and might suggest such a system was now legal on German roads. Who in their right mind would really think that Germany already had full self-driving legislation? Germany will probably get the legislation underway for autonomous driving when cars have been driving autonomously in the US or Asia for 10 years already. Then Germany might slowly start, only start, to think about implementing legislation for autonomous driving.
In other news, Nissan has revealed a really interesting electric car, the Nissan Ariya, which looks surprisingly futuristic for Nissan. What's going on there? The Cybertruck effect is apparently already starting to have an impact, it seems, forcing other car makers to try more futuristic designs. A very welcome development after decades of very little progress design-wise. This all-electric SUV will sport two battery versions. A smaller one with 65 kWh for around 200 miles of range, and a larger one with 90 kWh capacity for around 300 miles of range. The strongest version will allow for a 0 to 60 mph or a 0 to 100 kph acceleration time of around 5 seconds, which is not bad. The starting price is around $40,000 before incentives for the smaller battery version. The larger one will probably be in the $50,000 to $60,000 range. Unfortunately though, the car will be available in the States in the second half of 2021, with Europe following even later. But still, we are glad to see such new refreshing car designs. And other car makers besides Tesla now also starting to produce compelling electric cars with good real-world ranges in the 300-mile area, which will be needed to have even the slightest chance against Tesla.
And while Nissan learns from Cybertruck and tries more aggressive designs, BMW thought, why not do the exact opposite and surprise the world with the most boring and bland design possible? Well, also quite good strategy, you know? Why not? They revealed the production version of their BMW iX3 SUV, and it certainly wins the title ugliest electric car on the planet, that's for sure. It will sport an 80 kilowatt hour battery pack, which will enable a range of 285 miles in the WLTP cycle, so real world probably not more than 240 miles, tops. And with options such as the Model 3 and soon the Model Y, we really wonder why anyone in his or her right mind would ever buy this car here instead of a Model Y. And now finally air taxis again. There's a lot going on with the company Lilium, you know, the air taxi company from Munich, which plans on making their Lilium Jet a mainstream product as soon as possible.
They now partnered with Toray Industries, a leading supplier in the aerospace industry, specialized on aerospace materials and especially carbon fiber products. So Lilium basically already wants to establish a supply chain for their future manufacturing plant. Lilium expects commercial operation of their Lilium Jet by 2025. And last week on Friday, Lilium gave a presentation in Tampa, Florida, to advertise the benefits of the Lilium Jet for the Tampa Bay region. This would allow to reach St. Petersburg from Tampa in only 8 minutes.
No, not this St. Petersburg, this one here. However, the trips would be quite expensive in the beginning, around 90 bucks per trip. As with every new technology, prices are very high at first, but as adoption grows, the prices will also eventually come down. So sooner or later, we suspect that such trips will not cost more than a regular Uber or Lyft ride does these days. And Lilium also showed renderings of how they imagine their future vertiports, as they call the airports for the Lilium Jet. These vertiports could be easily built on top of existing structures, high above street level in order to minimize noise levels. The Lilium Jet will have a range of 300 kilometers and a top speed of 300 kilometers per hour, and will be able to fly for 1 hour straight. This is far beyond the capabilities of any other current air taxi. And this is why the Lilium air taxi is currently one of our favorite air taxi designs.
Then in the JS Disruption report from last week, we already talked about a new US legislation which will allow Hyperloop to become mainstream. We will put the link to our last week's video into the description. And not only Virgin Hyperloop cheered this legislation as a landmark legislation that will take Hyperloop mainstream, but no, this legislation was being noticed worldwide and could enable Hyperloop projects to move along faster all around the globe. In the US, Pittsburgh took notice and plans to move forward with the Great Lakes Hyperloop, to which it will be connected, allowing for a trip to Chicago in 45 minutes, instead of currently 7 hours by car. According to the Great Lakes Hyperloop plan, Pittsburgh will be connected to Cleveland and Columbus, probably Indianapolis, and to Chicago. Later, this will be connected to the Missouri Hyperloop network, including the cities of St. Louis and Kansas City. The UAE also took notice. This could indeed accelerate the planned Dubai-Abu Dhabi Hyperloop route. That's exactly why we need a strong and innovative America. They just lead the way with innovation. It has always been like this, and hopefully will continue to be like this. A pro-technology-oriented legislation is really important. And luckily, it seems that even in times of brutal crisis, the US hasn't lost its spirit of innovation.
And on this channel, we also talk about disruptive spaceflight technologies, about which you can learn more in this video here.
So thanks for watching the JS Disruption Report, and I'd say, on to the future!
Why am I so thirsty all the time?
Austin.
Mm-hmm. The cricket.
Cricket.